Hello friends, and welcome to today's episode. The world turned upside down for a father when he got heartbreaking news. His beloved son had cancer. Instead of giving up, the man chose to keep fighting for his son's life. He didn't know that he would soon be surprised by another shocking fact. No parent can stand to see their kids hurt, and they would do anything to make it stop. A parent's worst fear is that something bad will happen to their children. This is what a father from Shorewood, Illinois went through. Jeff Ott had always helped the people around him and lived a life of honor and care. But one day, when his oldest son got a heartbreaking diagnosis, he found himself in a bind and needed help for his beautiful family. Also, the caring father found out something terrible just days before the treatment that would save his son's life. Jeff's wife and the mother of his children left him alone to deal with the situation, which was both shocking and sad. Jeff had never thought that he would have to take care of his kids by himself. He was shocked and broken, but what else could he do? He could leave his kids, like he did with his wife, or he could stick by them. This is what he picked. Jeff was a paramedic and firefighter for more than a decade. He spent that time helping other people. After helping people and saving lives for 11 years, he was in a tough spot one day and needed help and support more than ever. Jeff didn't choose to become a single parent on January 26, 2016, but that's what happened. He was hit hard just days before he found out something else that changed everything he thought he knew. Brandon, the oldest of Jeff's 7 children, was identified with Langerhans cell histiocytosis, or LCH. This is a very rare type of cancer in which too many white blood cells build up in the body and form tumors. In December 2015, the lump first showed up. After that, a doctor found a growth above the child's eye. Jeff was shocked, scared, and in a lot of pain when he found out what was wrong with Brandon. "I was shocked," he said. "I wasn't ready for that." Jeff was devastated when he heard that his son was sick, but he knew he had to be strong and keep going. When his wife left him and the kids at a time when they needed her the most, he was already at the bottom of his life. Brandon's mom turned her back on him just 4 days before he was to have surgery to remove a tumor from his head. This surgery would have saved his life. Lucky for him, his father was still around, and in the days that followed, Jeff became his son's biggest supporter. The Frankfort fireman had to take care of his 7 children, who were between 9 and 18 months old at the time, by himself after his wife left him. At the same time, he had to hide the pain he felt every day as he watched his beloved Brandon suffer. "I was shocked when someone told me my son had cancer. Like, my jaw dropped," Jeff said. The Illinois single dad said that his sister, Cindy McDorman, was the only other person who could help him take care of his kids. The woman from Galesburg was happy to step up and help out her brother. Brandon, Julie, Natalie, Emily, Collie, Noah, and Benjamin, who were Jeff's kids, could count on both their dad and their aunt. But soon after, in May 2016, Aunt Cindy was diagnosed with breast cancer, which was another sad event for the Otts. But it wasn't the first time she had trouble with her health. Cindy had 2 operations to remove tumors above her optic nerve, the first when she was 21 and the second when she was 2 months pregnant a few years later. Brandon thought of his aunt as a fighter, so he asked her to hold his hand while he fought for his health. Cindy was said to be in recovery after having a double mastectomy, so she stayed with Brandon for at least a week every month during his weeks-long chemo treatments. She was proud of her young nephew's strength, courage, and ability to keep going even when things were hard. Jeff was glad to have his sister there, who, according to him, helped out as much as she could. At the time, the Shorewood dad said this about his role in his kids' lives. "I've happily taken on the part of Mr. Mom without directly asking for help. A lot of people have reached out to me to offer help, and I'm very thankful." Jeff's only support was his sister. His oldest child was going through chemo, and some of his other children had cognitive and behavioral problems like autism. He split his time between home, work, and regular trips to the doctor. Even though what happened to him was scary, Jeff didn't give up. He cared for his kids as their mom and dad, and worked hard to provide for them. Jeff wrote on a fundraiser page he set up online in August 2016 that his son's cancer was treated with chemotherapy for 52 weeks. Since the GoFundMe account was made, 339 people have given $20,965 toward the $50,000 goal. The father of 7 asked his community to pray for his family and help him get money so he could hire caretakers for his children with special needs so he could work full-time. Jeff had been a firefighter since 1998. At the end of December 2016, he said that the community outreach and support had been great. He said that lots of people had helped out and surprised his kids with gifts, making the holiday season special for them. The Make-A-Wish Foundation even paid for the Otts to go to Disneyland in California for the holidays. Jeff's network of people who cared about him grew over time. In September, he and his family joined a neighborhood church. Nick Sondeno, the leader of the church, said that a lot of families and regular churchgoers helped and supported the Otts. The members worked hard to find ways to help the Ott family in other ways besides giving them food and taking care of their children. The minister also praised Jeff for how hard he worked and how much he loved his kids even when things were very hard. Nick liked how patient and kind the single dad was, and he said he had never seen someone go through so much and still have hope. After 7 years, Brandon is healthy and cancer-free, and his family is doing well. They got together to celebrate Easter and shared their happiness by sharing a touching picture from the day. Jeff's biggest son is all grown up and has reached all of his goals. In October 2023, he will be 16 years old. We hope that the Otts will keep making great memories and enjoying life for many years to come. Please pray for them, and if this story touched your heart, please let us know what you think. That's it for today, friends. Please let us know what you think about this story. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you soon for more amazing stories.